healthcare is intensely personal, and we need to do a better job of making sure that everyone has the ability to make the choices that work best for them. I was pregnant with my twins, Emma and Henry, and there was a great deal of fear that I was going to deliver twins at 24 weeks in a day. From there, fortunately, they were able to stop the labor and I was sent home on bed rest. Of course, when you're on bed rest, then you can't really work. I went through all of what I had left for paid time off, went through all of my disability, and then went through all of my unpaid FMLA. That ran out about a week before Emma and Henry were born. And so at that point, although I worked for an amazing organization, they had to let me go. We decided that while it was going to be tight, it was going to be the best decision for our family, for me to stay home and be with the kids. I think it ended up being the right choice for us. But what really hit home for me was thinking about how many women and families don't actually get to make this choice for themselves. When we talk about healthcare, having a living wage, paid family medical leave, affordable childcare, all of these things are part of economic security. We have a system in our state, in our country, that doesn't really take care of families. And what I hope to fight for in the legislature is the ability for every family to make the choice that works best for them. We are not prioritizing people, and we have to do a better job.